Now, in this example, the middle term has not been split for us, so we'll have to factor this on our own from the beginning, which we did in section 6.2. So the first thing we'll do, notice that the variable C will not be part of the GCF because the 5 doesn't have a C. But we do need to check for GCF between 2, 7, and 5. Since there's not a number that will go into 2, 7, and 5, there's not a GCF. So there's no GCF from the beginning. Now we can move to product sum. We need a product of 2 times 5, which is 10, and the sum of 7. So we need two numbers that when we multiply them, we get 10, but when we add those same two numbers, we get 7. We can try 2 times 5, which does equal 10, and 2 plus 5, which equals 7. So since those numbers work, we'll bring down our ends and fill in the middle with 2C and 5C. Now we're ready to group. Notice that the variable C is common to both terms, so we'll factor out the C with the lowest exponent. Also notice that 2 is common to both terms, so we can pull out that entire 2. Now you're probably saying, okay, but in the past we've gone over here. You can still do it that way. If you're looking for the GCF between the same number, it's going to be that number itself. But if you want to go this route, we can divide both of those by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. This is our stopping point, and our GCF will be 2C. Dividing both of these terms by a GCF of 2C, we get these 2's cancel. C squared divided by C is C. Be careful here. 2C divided by 2C is 1. Just like 5 divided by 5 is 1. Now we can move to our second group. C won't be part of the GCF, but notice that 5 is common to each term, so we can pull out that 5. Dividing each term by the 5 that we factored out, notice here that the 5's cancel, leaving us with C. And 5 divided by 5 is 1. Now that we have the same terms in each parentheses, we can write our answer.